Dr. Paul Mason, salt and blood pressure. What is the latest science? What is the effect of fructose and nitric oxide on blood pressure?
There's not sufficient evidence at this stage to limit sodium intake. So when we say salt, we normally talk about sodium chloride, and the sodium is what people get concerned about. Just for an example, in I think it was September of 2017, the Australian Dietary Guidelines removed any upper limit for sodium intake for individuals. That means that I can now tell you to have as much salt as you would like and not be in contravention of the Australian Dietary Guidelines. Trouble is the fluid volume of your blood is governed by how much sodium you have. And if you don't have enough sodium in your blood vessels, then number one, you'll often feel thirsty because your body's saying, we need more fluid, we don't have enough fluid, so you'll drink a lot. But then because you don't have the sodium, remember the sodium's necessary to hold the fluid inside your blood vessels, so you'll end up urinating it out. So people on ketogenic diets, because you often need more salt on ketogenic diets, if they're finding that they're constantly thirsty and they're urinating a lot, so when they drink it just passes out, it's often a sodium deficiency. And one of the other major symptoms people will feel is that if they stand up quickly, they'll feel dizzy because their blood pressure isn't enough to maintain the blood pressure going up to the brain. You're basically starving the brain of oxygen, of its blood supply. So they're two common symptoms of sodium deficiency, easily fixed just by having more sodium in the diet. Well, fructose directly contributes to insulin resistance. So we've got some beautiful studies where they've actually had groups of children who have been consuming a lot of sugar, which is 50% fructose, 50% glucose. And they've taken out the fructose, but they've basically replaced it with same amounts of glucose. So the total carbohydrates have stayed the same, but the fructose has reduced. And in those studies, even very short periods in the space of, you know, just over a week, they've been able to demonstrate significant reductions in liver fat, and have no doubt that liver fat is fatty liver is a direct cause of insulin resistance. Now, if you have insulin resistance, we said before, that means that insulin's not working properly. So then your body will increase the level of insulin. Now, the thing about insulin not working properly is it's very tissue specific. So while it might not work as it normally does in your muscle tissue, helping your muscles to take sugar out of circulation, it can still work relatively well at the fat level. So help your fat stores take sugar out. And it can still work quite well at the kidney level. And one of the jobs of insulin at the kidney level is to actually hold on to sodium. So that's actually a much more important factor for increasing the sodium in your body and causing high blood pressure than is the amount of sodium that you consume. If you consume a modicum of sodium but have very high insulin levels, your body's going to try very hard to hold on to all of that sodium. You can, on the other hand, consume a whole lot of sodium but have very good low insulin levels, and any excess sodium that you consume will just come out in your urine. High insulin levels prevent that from happening effectively. So fructose causes high blood pressure predominantly through the mechanism of insulin resistance. Now, it can also interact with nitric oxide levels via uric acid, and some of your viewers may have seen lectures by Professor Robert Lustig. He did a famous lecture that's about 11 years old now, and he's got quite complicated diagrams in there that demonstrate how fructose metabolism leads to changes in uric acid levels, which then lead to changes in nitric oxide. And nitric oxide is actually something that relaxes blood vessels and actually helps lower blood pressure. And if you interfere with that pathway, then that's another potential mechanism to increase blood pressure. But I believe the predominant one is the sodium retaining effects of insulin at the kidneys.
Dr. Mason says there's not enough scientific evidence to limit the intake of our salt, which is sodium chloride. In 2017, the Australian Dietary Guidelines removed any upper limits to sodium intake. The fluid volume of your blood is governed by sodium levels. If it's not enough, you feel thirsty, so you drink a lot. But without sodium, the blood will not hold fluids, so you simply urinate them out. People on a ketogenic diet often need more salt. So if you're on a ketogenic diet and you're constantly thirsty and need to urinate, it is likely a sodium deficiency. Also, when sodium deficient, You may feel dizzy when you quickly stand. Just add more sodium to your diet. Fructose directly contributes to insulin resistance. Sugar, which is 50% fructose, 50% glucose, in a study of children, which were divided into two groups, in the first group, they had foods with typical sugar carbohydrates. In the second group, they replaced the fructose 50% with 100% glucose. The results? The glucose group, within a week, had significantly reduced the fat in the liver. Fatty liver is a direct cause of insulin resistance. Insulin not working properly, so the body will increase insulin. While insulin may stop working well in muscle tissue, for example, it can still work well in the fat tissue, storing sugar as fat. And it can still work well in the kidneys, causing them to hold onto sodium. This is a much more likely factor. Insulin not working well, kidneys hold onto sodium, high blood pressure. On the other hand, you can consume a lot of sodium if you have low insulin, if you are not insulin resistant. Then you will simply urinate excess sodium out, no problem. Fructose causes high blood pressure, primarily through insulin resistance. It can also interact with nitric oxide through uric acid, as seen in Dr. Robert Lustig's work. He showed that fructose metabolism leads to changes in uric acid levels, which leads to interruptions in nitric oxide. Nitric oxide relaxes blood vessels. When interrupted, this leads to high blood pressure. Dr. Mason concludes with, "I believe the predominant cause of blood pressure rise is sodium-retaining effects of insulin at the kidneys."